can't believe that Clayton is dead. I mean, I know that he had some faults. He pulled some stunts, but...
Well, he almost got us killed on more than one occasion.
Despite everything that he put us through. There was just something always kind of... lovable about Clayton.
Well, apparently not everybody shared our sentiment.
Maybe Webb got caught up in some sort of intelligence war and Palmer murdered him.
When Palmer took me hostage, he kept bragging about being a forensic artist. The way Webb was killed is too sloppy for Palmer. I know the way he thinks.
Don't get inside Palmer's head, Harm. It's not someplace you want to be.
Maybe the only way to find him.
Unless he finds you first. Webb was not the only one that Palmer had a grudge against.
I'm not afraid of Palmer, Mac.
Well, I am for you.
I hope he does come after me. That'd make finding him a whole lot easier.
You're holding something out on me, aren't you?
I figured he was trying to involve me in another one of his spook operations. When I finally did answer it, he was gone.
You had no way of knowing.
I know that. I still feel guilty. Guy reached out to me, I let him down. Palmer's out there. Somewhere. I can feel him.
Does Clayton Webb know about this?
Webb?
No.
Mr. Webb is very careful not to get his hands dirty.
That's why the company has wet boys like you, huh?
Wet boys? You've been reading too many spy novels.
That's what they call assassins these days, isn't it?
I prefer to think of myself as a forensic artist. I mean, any psycho can walk up to some poor soul, put a gun to the base of his skull, and blow his brains out of his forehead. But it takes true artistry to have that same guy choke on a hot dog at a baseball game in front of 15,000 people, or suffer a stroke on the dance floor at his daughter's wedding.
He's like a disease. You know that... that sick, eerie feeling you get just before the flu attacks your body?
Harm, I'm staying here tonight.